Good morning, students. Welcome to fifth session of social science. In previous session, we have studied about archaeological sources, and this session I am going to explain literary sources. The literary sources means something which has been written. The literary sources of this period are religious work and commentaries on the classical texts. Religious works means works they have done on the basis of their religion that was prevailing in medieval period. And the commentaries. Commentary means a set of explanatory note on a written work. Classic means judge over a period of time to be the highest quality. Means commentaries they have given on the classical text which was prevailing that time. Manuscripts have been found which date back to the early medieval period. They are written on palm leaves, bark of birch trees and animal skins. Manuscripts means written by hand. So all these scripts they were found on this palm leaves, bark of birch and animal skin. All these manuscripts have been written and compiled by the Jain and Buddhist monks. The number and the variety of textual records increased manifold in this period. Now what happened gradually that many people they were writing. Many textual records they were increased. Earlier suppose they were written on they have written only 5, later on they exceeded and it was more than 15 to 20 in this medieval period only. Paper began to be used widely now. Now what happened that people started using paper for writing all this scripts and this literature, and the number of paper manuscripts are seen to exceed except written on other types of surfaces. Now what happened? Now in this medieval period, many people started using paper to write their manuscripts, and that manuscripts written on paper exceeds, means that was more than the manuscripts which are written on other types of surfaces. It was in this period that the paper became a popular surface for those writing. Means in this time what happened, paperwork that people they were using paper for writing many kinds of records. First they have started using for writing chronicles. Chronicle means a record of historical event that made in the other in which they happened. Petitions means application to a court for any legal action. Judicial records, records means having to do with the law, court or judge, related to law and court. Records of accounts, accounts means record of money that has been spent or received. This business people, kind of people they were maintaining. And the taxes, holy taxes, taxes related to religion. And for transcribing the teachings of saint. Transcribing means to put thoughts or speech into written form. So all these that people they started using paper surface for writing all these records. Now these scripts are reliable sources as the historian, since they are most concerned the economy, polity and society. Now these manuscripts are more reliable. Reliable means on which we all can trust. Why it is reliable? Because everything that was written on a surface, especially on paper. The three kind of informations there in these manuscripts, related to economy, related to polity and society. However, there was no printing press in those days. Now paper they were using and no printing was there, means whichever they were recording, they were writing by hand. Manuscripts were, as the name imply, manually produced. Manuscript means written by men or written, handwritten. Sometimes valuable information as original manuscripts are copied by the other scribes. Now what was happening? First person, he have written that one manuscript. Now others, what they have done? By seeing that manuscript, they have written. Means copying was going on. First person has written, by seeing that second has written, by seeing that third has written, likewise. Inevitably means unavoidable. Now this process adventurously changed to the original text to some text due to errors or commission. Here this changes was unavoidable. Why? Because first one script was written, by seeing that another has written, by seeing that third person had written a likewise, because of some errors or some omissions, some mistakes, that original text has been changed into any another text. These changes in the text over centuries led to fourth generation or latest text that different substantially from the original. Now what happened, as that people, they were copying from the original text, when it reached to the fourth generation, there was a vast difference between the original text and that the later text. Moreover, textual revision at different points of time also often led to drastic changes over time. As usually that there were changes were going on, the texts which were revised lastly have the many different points regarding the time. This is particularly noticeable in the chronicle of 14th century chronicler Ziauddin Barani. Now in what happened, this changes we can easily see or easily notice in the chronicle of 14th century written by the chronicler Ziauddin Barani. Now Barani completed his chronicle in 1356. He was writing one chronicle and he have completed in 1356, but revised it 2 years later, possibly because it did not have the desired result of gaining Firoz Shah Tughlaq's favor. Now he was writing for Firoz Shah Tughlaq. After completing his chronicle in 1356, he got to know or realized that the result is not in favor of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. So what he have done, after 2 years of writing chronicle, he revised it. Revised means to write again or record again. He have written again it, and then the later version therefore is substantially different from the earlier one. Now what happened, it was having two chronicle now, first version and second version. Second version was totally different what he have written in the first version. Hence it may seen that consideration other than factors reporting often dedicated the content of chronicle. Now here we can see that whichever information we are getting through chronicle is not totally correct. Some considerations are there. Consideration means whenever that person is writing, suppose Barani was writing a chronicle for Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Firoz Shah Tughlaq was thinking or was supposed to have that chronicle in his favor. So some consideration is there, favorism is there. So we can say that chronicle is having some kind of favorism instead of all correct facts. In this way, a historian has to be very careful while extracting facts from handwritten sources. Now what happened, as some chronicles, they are not very factful. Some considerations are also involved there. So whenever a historian is using that extract, using that resources, he have to be very careful. There are several authentic and large unadulterated works. Means after this having some authentic means reliable, which are correct. Some many works are also there which are not altered. Means when that people they have recorded it, they have recorded very carefully and there is no change. Among this unadulterated works, we are having few biographies. These include biographies of Mughal emperor like Babur, autobiography Tuzak-e-Baburi, Jahangir Tuzak-e-Jahangiri, the biography of Humayun written by his sister Gulbadan Begum, Humayunnama, and Abul Fazl's Ghosim's ology on his master Akbar-Nama. We have also literary and historical work written by Abul Fazl, Faizi, Firdausi, Amir Khusro, etc. We have also revenue and land records of some ruler which throw light on the administrative system during the medieval period. Beside this, autobiographies and biographies, we are having some more records. Records related to revenue. Revenue means income, and land, how much land was there, how much was cultivated. Likewise, every record of this revenue and land was there, which was giving light to the administrative system of medieval period. Among the famous Sanskrit composition is Raj Tarangani, written by Kalhana, which records the history of Kashmir. Beside this, autobiography, biographies, after this having that records of revenue and lead, we are having some more scripts. Among that, Sanskrit Rajtarangini, that was written by Kalhana, was famous, and this records the history of Kashmir. Next, we are having accounts of foreign travelers. The previous that we have studied, that was the accounts, or that was the work of the Indian people. Now we will see that accounts of foreign travelers. The foreign travelers who visited India during this medieval period were Al-Biruni, Ibn Battuta, Domingo Pais, Niccolo Conti, Francois Bernier, and Jean Baptiste Tavernier. These are the foreign travelers, those who traveled India, and after they have written all informations. The invaluable accounts they left behind have contributed a storehouse of information about the political, social and economic condition of India in those days. Now they have written a lot of accounts related to political, politics, social, related to society and economic conditions of India. And all these accounts are a kind of a large contribution, or you can say that is a kind of storehouse of information of India in the medieval period.